Oh, yes, it is a very, very wonderful Monday morning here on Urban Today, and we are glad you're part of us. But did you know that how many weeks now, about 2 weeks of them now, close to 2 weeks, the NRM primaries are still making headlines, and we are still talking about them. Yet we still have other things to focus on. But the NRM primaries were, of course, very huge and, yes, interesting. And so here we are still talking about them. That aside, Kanyamunyu went on his knees and apologized for his alleged murdering of Akena. That aside, we have, you people, there's a lot going on. A very prominent man has died, allegedly, of coronavirus. Well, with me here is Henry Sekanjoko, and of course we're going to look at those stories and many more that are making headlines this morning. And if you're not awake, please get up and go to work. Henry, good morning.
Good morning, Lynn. How are you today?
I'm very well,
thank
you.
How was your night?
Beautiful, yes.
And the weekend?
Long and lovely.
Mine was also okay.
You look fresh, yes.
Yeah,
you look fresh.
As usual.
Uh-huh.
And then though we started on a, you know, a bad note, we
yes.
lost one of our big investors in the country. That's FX Chitaka.
Mm-hmm.
I think he's one of the first Ugandans that invested in private, you know, mm-hmm. owned pharmacies, veterinary especially.
Oh, he was into veterinary?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what he first invested in. But I think along the way, he, you know, to know other things, and but it's really unfortunate that we lost him. You know, it feels bad, you know, losing such big investors in the country.
That's true. That's very true.
That we need to.
But
to
again,
keep
again, these are inevitable things. You know, as we age, as we grow up, you know, things keep changing.
That's
so
true.
Definitely, he probably his time was up.
That's
Who
true.
Knows? You know, sometimes you have to accept this.
He was about 85.
You see, so he was in his evening years.
Mm. Mm. But and we thank him that he has been able to invest in his country. He has employed quite a number of Ugandans. So I think he's a big reward awaits him in heaven.
Anything, any more that we don't know about him that he might know?
I think he was also the owner of Quaritch Chemicals, you know.
Right.
That, yeah, so
right.
He was quite a big investor in the country.
Yes.
And you know that factory has, you know, produced quite a number of vaccines,
mm-hmm.
ARVs. And, you know, other
Quaritch Chemicals in Luzira.
Exactly. That
Absolutely.
One.
Oh, yes, oh, yes.
Yeah. So he's a big loss to the country.
Absolutely. And so there we have lost a very, very huge person. And because of the investment into the country, we have lots of medication coming in from Quaritch Chemicals.
Right.
And I have a feeling they'll definitely partner with the relevant, you know, stakeholders in coming up with a vaccine that we are all working on, looking forward to, actually. Well, may his soul rest in peace. And we move on to the NRM, of course, primaries. The other week we had members of parliament, and also those ones were also, you know, held, but there were still issues. Then the last week on Friday, we had primaries for local council 5 chairpersons. We also had mayors and city mayors. So that also
but
went.
Linda, the beauty about those primaries that we had over the weekend,
yes,
LOC 5, you know, and city mayors, Kampala Lord Mayor, they were not that violent.
You know?
Like we did.
Like
you know, like we had for parliamentary ones. Yeah.
And yet this is where politics happens.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So I think, can I say that sometimes it's intentional that, you know, we go violent?
Intentional?
I mean,
how do you mean?
How come this one was not that violent?
Maybe because...
Is it because we, you know... We
it's
have
not
learned,
such
we
a
have,
big place.
We have, it is. Is it because we have learned from the previous one that we had that this one was not that violent?
And perhaps maybe because the chairman, the NRM chairman, issued stern warnings and said, we are tired of your violence. If you cannot have a, we shall cancel them.
Mm.
So please. Maybe it could have played
so
a role.
So these guys said, we don't want to go this far. Maybe we should, you know, be peaceful and all that. But it was really good and we thank God we didn't register any cases of violence.
That's right. Thankfully, no violence, but big shots. Who lost the petition? Who lost in these primaries have petitioned the NRM Electoral Commission. And guess what?
Mm-hmm.
300 over
370. That's quite a high
guys,
number.
Guys.
You know, the previous election, we've not had, you know, such high cases, such, you know, high cases.
Yes, I mean, what could have gone wrong?
But of course, you know, most of them lost and they're not ready to take it up. So, and what is interesting, majority of them are ministers.
Yes.
Even those that had given up. You remember Mary Carroll Crute?
Yes. She also petitioned.
Yeah, she's petitioned, you can imagine. Yes, she was one of those that came out to say that, it's like she had considered, but if you look at the list of those that have petitioned, mm-hmm. She's one of those that have petitioned.
This is interesting. I thought she was one of those people.
And she told New Vision that her team, her campaign team, because she's saying that for her she had given up, but then her team said, no, you cannot just let go of this.
This is a behavior I've seen with most NRM people.
Thinking that, okay, if you said that you had considered, then what forces you to come up?
Is her team, like you said. But
what's worrying, the petition the president?
Henry, this is a behavior I've seen around NRM.
Mm.
In many instances, my team, my people, my supporters, you know? My blah, 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 mm-hmm. blah, blah, blah.
You remember what happened in Koboko municipality?
Exactly.
My voters have asked me to
My voters, my...
petitioned, you know, the Penda petition to take to the president. But you know, it's like these guys have no trust in the Electoral Commission because most of them have petitioned the president.
Their Electoral Commission. Seriously. So imagine what that looks like on us.
Mm-hmm.
We have a National Electoral Commission, which they don't trust, but uh-huh. now they do not trust their own. Where are we headed?
I know.
Where are we headed? 375 petitions.
That's quite a big number.
Anyway, some of these petitions, Henry, have been sent to the district tribunals. Yeah. The president said they should institute some of these at district level so that they can go on ground and you know, audit. Whatever questions, whatever came out of the
primaries. Of course, some of the petitioners are accusing the electoral officials of being biased and, you know, failing voters and all that kind of thing.
It's so, so funny. The ministers, no, the ones who lost, that is one category. Now, the ministers who lost as well, including Mary Karoro Krut, including...
There's Isaac Musumba,
exactly.
There's Rukutana himself.
Yes. Rukutana is in
he's also petitioning,
in prison,
by the
and
way.
He's still petitioning.
Yeah, he's petitioning. There's Joy Kabasi, who lost to Sech Kubo.
But that one should just chill. Sech Kubo. She has not
been chanceful at all. We have alluded to Tumwesije, who was won by Katesh. Yes. So I don't know, because everyone, you know, could even see that the guy won.
But
so
surely,
really
Katyashumba, it was like he swept
exactly
the whole of Shema.
So I don't know what.
So what is Elioda
petition? What case Elioda is putting, but he's saying that this was not a genuine win.
Henry, let me ask. Why do you think they are quick to petition the president? Does this mean that all the powers lie with him?
Yeah, because maybe he's bigger than the party. And these guys are saying that he's the only person whose, you know, decision we can take. We cannot trust Tango Doi, yet he's
okay.
The one in charge.
So they're jumping the electoral commission
to the chairman,
the party chairman.
I think they find the president, you know, more fairer compared to the electoral boss, to the party electoral boss.
If the voters were not fair with them, why should they expect the president to
And the president has already warned those
yes.
that rigged the vote because...
To concede.
We already know some of them.
He actually said that he has given them a three-day ultimatum to members who participated in vote rigging to come clean or face prosecution.
And do you know that some of those have petitioned, so I don't know what's going to happen.
You guys, NRM never ceases to amaze me, especially... during this time, primaries. Now also, relatedly, the Electoral Commission has set nomination dates for presidential and members of parliament candidates. Now this is not the NRM.
This is the
National Electoral Commission has set nomination dates for presidential and members of parliament. So we'll look forward to how that goes. You know, it is always pompous. It's always wonderful, crowded. You know, you're going with our you know, our person, mm-hmm. Henry, we're all over the place.
And I guess me wondering, how are we going to observe those SOPs?
Exactly, that's my thought, you
because,
know.
Because I know it's fanfare, people driving, you yes. know. It's riding always, with those border borders, matatus.
It's always a glamorous event. Mm. So, well, I hope they have the
I think SOPs. Police will be on standby and they will be able to control the, you know, those crowds.
Definitely. Mm. Definitely. Let's move away from the elections. Now, on to Kanyamunyu. You guys remember, let me jog your memory a little bit. Kanyamunyu allegedly murdered. Mm. Shot Ewan Akena, just down here at
Kenneth
Lugogo,
Akena,
because he scratched his car. Allegedly, that is the story we have. Now, he has been in court for that time. His case had been adjourned indefinitely.
Yeah.
That was him alongside his girlfriend, as you can see on your screen, his girlfriend, Cynthia Mnyangwari, and alleged they have been in court and the case was adjourned indefinitely, of course, due to...
Yeah, they've been in court since 2016.
Yes.
5 years almost.
That's right. Mm. Now, due to COVID-19, the case had been adjourned indefinitely. But now, Akena, through his associates, petitioned the Acholi Religious Leaders Peace Initiative and the Acholi Culture Institute, and they agreed, well, you know, in part, to allow him get to that part where he says, please forgive me.
Wow, that speaks a lot.
Volumes.
A lot of it. Because is he saying that, look, you guys, look, I'm guilty of what I did?
Though he does not say I am guilty.
He doesn't say that. But he says I'm remorseful.
Mm-hmm.
And I ask for your forgiveness.
Okay.
At what point do you ask for forgiveness? Because that happens if you have committed an offense, right?
Exactly.
Yes.
And if you're guilty.
Exactly. So, Kanyamunyu going to Acholi and then facing these elders that look here, I ask for your forgiveness. It speaks quite a lot.
It speaks volumes, big volumes, big
and,
volumes.
But all in all, me, I think it's a good move because look here, Lynn, we are going to at least save on the time that the courts were, you know, going to spend.
That's true.
Investigating this case and then the resources that, you know, government was going to invest in pursuing this case.
Mm-hmm.
So they call it pre-bargaining.
Yeah.
I think so.
It's a form of pre-bargaining.
Yeah, I see it as pre-bargain
because this is, they say it is an Acholi justice system that, you know, has been in existence before.
Mm.
So if somebody commits a crime, you just apologize and then there is a certain compensation set on you. So if you fulfill that, then they will definitely...
Lynn, what makes it even more interesting? Because
yes.
When you look at the mat or put definition,
yes.
The Acholis define it as a process. It's a process in Acholi culture that is carried out in the case of intentional or accidental killing of an individual. Mark the two words, intentional
or accidental
killing of an individual.
So either way.
So by this guy coming out to say that you guys forgive me and then looking at the definition, it points, you know, it shows that maybe this guy is guilty. Maybe we are not courts of law. We cannot, you know, decide the case here. But it shows that Kanyamunyu has, you know, something to do with this. Because, you know, if you look at the definition of matoput, you know, it clearly shows that maybe he's guilty, maybe he's not. Of course, we wait for the courts to tell us.
What they have actually done is that they have asked him for 10 heads of cattle, 3 goats, and this is the blood composition that is enshrined in the matoput.
Yes, matoput.
So this is what consists of the matoput. For it to be conclusive, 10 heads of cattle, 3 goats. If he fulfills this, then he goes forward. But
I'm told there's also some bit of money which they're not telling us about.
Obviously. What they also clarify, this does not affect the court process.
Of course.
So if the court
justice
process still goes on,
prevail.
But that also is very important. It's a very important step he's taken. So we wait to see how that, my goodness.
Mm.
Okay, well, bravo to you. By that, he has confidence.
Yeah, eh? He has confidence.
My goodness.
But also, then there are also allegations.
That what?
That the ghost. There are rumors about that a ghost was on his case. I don't know how true that is, but of course.
Yes, yes.
People said that, you know that
those things Akena's
ghost,
missed.
You know, was giving him sleepless nights and all that. So we don't know what will happen.
Oh,
that
boy,
forced him to
oh
go
boy, poor
to
Acholi
and, you know, kneel before these elders and say, you guys, I'm remorseful and ask for your
please,
forgiveness.
Please, please have mercy on me. The ghosts are haunting me. Okay. Well
it's crazy.
Done. Mm. Well done. That's a very brave move.
Yeah.
Okay, now, elsewhere, not elsewhere, well, relatedly, in Uganda, we're still Uganda, then Tanzania, then that pipeline, finally. But Henry, I have had questions over and over and over over this oil. Well, I will not ask these questions today. Museveni, Magufuli have finalized an oil pipeline pact. By the way,
the host government agreement.
Yes, the host government agreement. Now, this pipeline goes all the way from Uganda through to Tanzania.
Yeah, 80% of it, you know, goes through Tanzania.
That's true. And this is something that the host government agreement, of course, once it is signed, brings in place the FID, that is the final investment decision, which we have been waiting for as long as I have known that we have oil in this country. Now, that's a very interesting move. Did you see how Magufuli was not anyway bothered by coronavirus?
But he has already told us from the word go that him and COVID, his country and COVID, life has been normal for them and continues to be
at
normal.
Least our president is safe, so
yeah, he's
sure.
Safe, at least wore a mask, and that is good.
Absolutely. Mm. Now, this project is supposed to cost $3.5 billion, and it will connect Uganda's oil fields to Tanzania's port of Tanga. Oil reserves were found in Uganda in 2006. Imagine, how many years ago?
Quite a
number. Okay, I can't calculate, because I think I was in A level or something.
Okay.
So now here I am. Hey, you guys, I need to test some of this oil money. It is said to become East Africa's first major oil pipeline. And they signed the host government agreement. It will cover 1,400 kilometers and will be the longest in the world. Eh?
Can imagine, yeah.
But Uganda keeps setting some
precedences,
standards.
Yeah.
Okay, now a quick one. These are some of the sub-counties through which this pipeline is going to go. Hoima, we have Buseruka, Chigorovia. Then it will also go through Kikuve, Kizirafumbi, Buhimba, Bugabo, Bugambe, Kakumiro, Chiryanga, Mpasana, Ntop. Oh, wow. This is very, very good. Chankwanzi, Gayaza, Mubende, Butorogo, Madudu, Kitenga, Gombo, Maju, Sembabule, Lugusulu, Sembabule Town Council, Mujala, Rwebitakuri, Rwengo, Rwengo Town Council, Ndagwe, Rwengo. Then we have Rakai, Navisagasa, Kasali, Rwanda, Kasasa, Kifamba, Kyotera, Kakuto, Chotera. So these are some of the affected sub-counties through which, of course, directly involved with the pipelines.
And I'm sure the Kenyan, rather the Tanzanian and the Ugandan governments have already, you know, compensated the people that are affected, because, you know, it comes with, you know,
many people
disorganized
be affected
and all that, yeah.
That's true. So, well, the meeting was aimed at giving guidance on key issues that were standing as they move towards the final investment decision that we await to see signed as soon as we can. And that's exactly what happened. As you can see on the map, that is the longest. Wow, well done Uganda, well done, bravo. So we wait to see that signed into and we start seeing some oil.
And of course, they're saying construction will take about 2 to 3 years for it to be complete, and I'm pretty sure when this is done we'll be able to get some money from oil.
Zenkoi, I've been singing about oil.
We have been waiting for oil production, you know,
forever.
For many years. But we hope, you know, it comes. You, it comes out this time around.
Absolutely. Yeah. All right, let's take a short break. When we return, we get into what's happening in the press. Back, you're still watching Urban Today. Please join our conversations on social media and be part of this. Don't miss out. Please don't miss out. Download the new Vision Digital Experience app and get all these stories in both audio and visual. Trust me, you don't know what you're missing out. Now, let me tell you, let me give you a little into this. We are going to have one of our, you know, colleagues here to explain further on the new Vision Digital Experience app. He's going to join us later in the show and, you know, give us a brief or a bigger picture. Yes, I didn't want to call it a brief, a bigger picture of what the new Vision Digital Experience app looks like and what it does. Now, before I can spoil that for you, let us see what is in today's paper. This diamond here, if you have the app with you, you can use the AR code and you scan, okay? So you scan this diamond and you'll have the video version of this story. Now into the paper, we have pass O level, chemistry, math, and ICT. We have a top murder case, Kanyamunyu opts for a Acholi justice system. Get the detailed story there. We also have a tribute, Francis Chitaka, to be buried on Sunday. Okay, get yourself a copy of the new Vision and get all these details. Meanwhile, there are over 4,400 jobs and tenders. So don't be there and say, Banange, sina job, sina mulimu, ndiwa, no. Please, don't miss out. There's also a detailed story and a detailed pipeline route, of course, on the oil pipeline. Mm-hmm. We have NRM lawyers examine 375 petitions over mad politics, polls. Okay, Museven backs 200 billion shillings job creation program. Where is it? What is it? Get a copy of the new Vision. Museven loads cultural institutions on patriotism. That is also in our community news this morning. But being a Monday, we have PACASA, okay? Don't miss out on PACASA. Many of us have side jobs, side hustles, and these are some of the success stories we carry. Now, Manya living his tech dream. So get details of what this tech dream is about and what makes him, you know, become the leading billionaire in technology. Okay, Pass O Level, like I told you, do not miss out on Pass O Level. We have it in there. There's business, telecoms to be forced to split mobile money from voice, data bundles. Hey, trouble drama. Mm-hmm. To work or not to work from home. Why, how, what that means, get the details in today's new Vision. Also in Monday, and rather every Monday, we hold health and beauty. And how safe are Ugandan patients? Find out. Get those stories in our health and beauty. And also quickly into sport, Liverpool had to tame. Get all those stories. Face of World Athletics, Bolt and Farah left the big stage for Cheptegei. That's the best news ever. Right, get yourself a copy of the new Vision at only 2,000 Uganda shillings.
All right. Nebukadde afulumidda angiranga bomulaba kulembeza omuntu ogugamba nti omugagga Kitaka ebyokufa corona bisatiza family yatandika quality chemicals ali solve gagga bwonikiriza mpozi waliwo n'ekibuzo nantaba anaita ku Bobi Wine ne NRM Kayunga biri mubukedde wono kolwa lero tulaba nti abawanguddwa ku bwa ssentebe bwa district bogedde kye bazzaako mu katabu ka kabukedde wono kolwa lero abemulugunya bisatu nsambu mbasatu ku kamifu ka NRM bananwalirira biri mu bukedde onakolwa leero ettemu lyeruweero likwasiza ba SFC byonna byonna mu katabo ka kabukedde kunakolwa leero Mpozitura mulimu nevi pass PL ye vichibina chomu kaga nechomu sambu. Nekubie mizanyo Arsenal. Arsenal njiraba kuchikopo ateta ya Gambia. Leeds elese evituli mpool. Arsenal ewade suvi ku Premier. Bienda vinje mkataba kwa kabu kedo. Unakulwa yeko nusuru kumilo karoka. Keguli ya venga osome visinga kwa neno.
All right. Bukede is on the newsstands as we talk, and so is the New Vision. 2,000 Uganda shillings for the New Vision, and Bukede at only 1,000 Uganda shillings. Also, subscribe to our e-papers. You get access to all Vision Group papers at just your fingertips, just like this, you know. It will be very nice for you. It's a good experience. Now, today, in today's court, it's a Monday. You've got to wake up. It reads, success at anything, we always come down to this. Focus and effort. And we control both. Dwayne Jensen.
Wow. So meaning without focus and effort, you cannot achieve success.
But how can you have success?
Some people just sit there.
How can you be successful at something?
Some people just sit there and then think. Mm-hmm. Things will come my way. They don't work
for
it.
Yeah. They're like those people who are in the Bible that they... Food fell from heaven.
Exactly. So Jensen is telling us that for you to get to achieve this success, you have to focus and then put in some effort.
No, not some. Put in the effort.
A lot of effort.
Put in the effort. Yes, so that you feel the hard work you're putting in, and the effort definitely will come your way. You will be successful. Mm. So don't just dilly-dally, okay? All right, so we'll take a break right now. When we return, we are still interrogating. We're still, trying to understand the issue of schools reopening.
Yeah, sure.
There's still so a big much question. At stake. Mm. Most schools are not ready. Others seem ready.
Parents don't have money.
Exactly. Yeah. You know, teachers are not sure they can, start. They think there's a lot that is not clear.
That's true.
So that is what we're going to go into when we return, of course. And please join the conversations on social media and be part of this discussion, because it affects you, it affects me, your neighbor, your sister, your brother. Everybody is literally affected. So we'll be right back.